In this video, I want to talk about the concept of pedal point and how it's been used by composers of all sorts of concert art music through the years. As we look at the organ, we notice that there are some pedals he or she can play with feet, and that's where we get the term pedal point, or at least that's one of the ways we get the term pedal point. There they are. It's kind of like a keyboard that's played with the feet. Some examples of organ using pedal point would be Johann Pachelbel's Prelude in D minor. Just listen to this piece and especially pay attention to the long sustained note you hear while the upper hand plays faster, more florid notes. So we start out with a sort of ponderous minor mode unison melody. The pedal hasn't occurred yet, but there it is, that long, low note. And notice how long it continues. Until there. Okay, another example would be Gordon Young's album Leaf, and again, this will be sectional. Sometimes the pedal will be used, sometimes it'll break, but let's listen. So it begins with the pedal on a long held note. And now the pedal leaves, there's no long held note. But the pedal returns. And again leaves. So we have like an A, B, A so far in the form. And finally the pedal returns again. A, B, A, B, A. So while that pedal note, that held note, didn't always fit in with every chord, every note played, it just held the whole thing together. It's a thread that glues the music together. We could classify pedal points in different categories. The type of pedal point used in both those organ examples is what I would call the long sustain. It's a single note that's held while the chords above it might change the prevailing harmony. The pedal might be part of it, but then it could be not part of it. So the pedal could be non-harmonic or non-chordal. An example of the long sustain I'm going to play is from the film Narnia, and it's the opening scene called The Blitz. Actually, a lot of film music, I would say 90% of the time, if you go to a movie, sit down in your seat with your popcorn and your Coke, you're going to hear a pedal point, if not at the very beginning of the film, certainly throughout the film. It's probably the most used compositional device by film composers. Anyway, let's listen to this cue called The Blitz. And you'll notice the pedal goes on for maybe 45 seconds or a minute. Even though a lot of other music is happening above it, it sort of holds everything together. Unique about this cue is that the sound of what I assume are B-52 bombers, their rumbling engine sort of merges with the sound of the low string and probably synthesizers and other instruments that are creating this long pedal. The pedal is a low G, right? Notice even though the chord changed, the pedal is still a low G. Okay, and there the pedal did break, and we moved on. Okay, another example by that same composer, same film, Narnia, is a Narnia lullaby. This is more like a folk music example, a drone, which is often used in folk. And here we have sort of an E. So the note is E, by one pipe that is held while the other pipe plays some folk music. Modal folk music. Okay, and I'm going to move on. The next example is actually a piece I've written called Fantasy on an Old English Air. The Old English Air is Drink to Me Only with Thine Eyes. And so this is sort of a piece that plays on that composition. But the opening minute of the piece, you're going to hear a low C pedal in the tuba and low woodwinds that continues for about a minute while some introductory themes are presented. Notice the pedal is still sounding. And right there is when the pedal is finally broken. Okay, now let's move on. So that's the long sustain. Another category of pedal I call ostinato rhythm. An ostinato is a repeated rhythm. And a great example of this would be Maurice Ravel's piece Bolero. And you're going to hear, actually this pedal, often the pedal is on the first scale degree of the key of the piece, sometimes called do, as in do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. This pedal is going to be on so, and that enables the composer to use both the tonic chord and the dominant chord, the chord built on the first scale degree and the chord built on the fifth scale degree, as the pedal will fit into both. So we're going to hear a pedal that's on so. So the note is the note G. This is in the key of C. And so that trumpet, that's the pedal. That ostinato rhythm just keeps reiterating itself over and over again on the note G, which is so in this key. Now the French horns have that pedal, ostinato rhythm. And actually that pedal goes on for most of the piece until a glorious moment when it does change, and what a release it is there. Anyway, another example of the ostinato rhythm would be in Gustav Holst's movement Mars, Bringer of War. The piece is called The Planets. Many people believe John Williams, film score for Star Wars, especially the Empire Strikes Back, the tune that represents Darth Vader, that Williams appropriates this sort of ostinato type of music that Holst uses in this movement. See if you agree. Anyway, we're going to hear a low G in 5/8. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. So that rhythm will repeat throughout the piece. Right now we hear some low brass rising through the orchestra. Eventually the entire orchestra will sound that ostinato rhythm on that G in unison in a powerful climax. Notice all the major and minor chords, consonant and dissonant. It doesn't matter what the chords are, the pedal holds it all together. And let's move on to another category I will call do-so. Sometimes the pedal isn't a single note, but instead it is two notes, do and so, used in alternation. So a very famous example of this would be the coffee movement from the Nutcracker. And just listen to a G and D, G, do-so-so-do, used here. In the bassoon, I believe, and strings, low strings. So in a sense, it's like two simultaneous pedals. And that sort of caravan do-so pattern helps place this in the Middle East for Tchaikovsky. And another do-so would be Carmina Burana by Carl Orff, the movement O Fortuna. Actually, several of the movements in Carmina Burana, but especially O Fortuna. So listen to this low D and A. D is do and A is so. There, I think it is bassoon. Okay, and we've all heard that one. I'm going to move on to multiple pedals. In other words, sometimes a pedal happens in one area of a piece and then another pedal happens in another area of the piece using, say, do and so as the pedals, not alternating like we just heard in the last set of examples. So the example I'm going to play for you is by Camille Saint-Saëns, his Carnival of the Animals, and the movement, the Aquarium. We hear a very, very striking piano florid arpeggios. A lot of people believe Alan Menken appropriated this music for the opening of the film Beauty and the Beast. If you have a chance, compare this example with that film cue. But anyway, here's the Aquarium, and we have a pedal on A. Right, so that's the key. It's sort of in an A minor. So a long pedal on A. Sort of a low string, maybe violin, viola. But then later on, we're going to move to E. So now there's a long pedal on E. Kind of like a retransition, a dominant pedal that's going to eventually catapult us back to A. So in this sense, we have sort of an ABA form that's supported by pedal on A and pedal on E and pedal on A again. Okay, and the last example I'd like to play is sometimes the pedal isn't in the bottom. A couple of the examples we've actually played, like the one we just heard, the pedal was sort of in the middle to the bottom, but a real striking example where the pedal is on the top, it completely flips everything, would be Stravinsky's Firebird Suite in the finale. You're going to hear the strings at the climax sawing away on a high B. So here's the closing to the Firebird Suite. And there, right there is the high string tremolo on a high B. And so while the chords are changing underneath that B, lots of really neat consonant and dissonant chords building tension, that B holds it all together. Pedal point is a great compositional device used by so many composers in so many types of music, not just concert art music, but all music. And I think it's one that's rather easy to implement.